السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. ویلکم بیک ڈیئر برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز. الحمدللہ, گوئنگ فارورڈ فرام اور پریویس کلاس وی ول بی ڈوئنگ کلاس نمبر 15 ٹوڈے انشاءاللہ. سو واٹ وی ڈوئنگ ٹوڈے از وی گوئنگ ٹو لرن سرٹن کانسیپٹس واٹ وی لرن ان دا پریویس کلاس اینڈ جسٹ ہیو اے کوئک ریویژن. سو ایز یوزوئل بیفور یو پروسیڈ وی گوئنگ ٹو do certain verbs which we used in the previous conversations. So the verb which we use learning is shariba. Shariba means he drank. Shariba, shariba is alif musanna, means two people drank. Sharibu, all of the men, waw represents hum. Sharibu, they all drank. Sharibat is means hiya, singular, tautanisi, and sharibata is again here tautanisi, and we have alif musanna for dual. Two women drank. Sharibna from hunna, all of those women. So we have sukoon coming on the lam kalima and then file attaching to the verb. Sharibna. Sharibta means anta. Shariptuma antum. Antuma and antum, the males. Shariptum. Sharipti. Shariptuma. Shariptunna. Shariptu, I drank. And Sharibna, we drank. So shariba is sami'a, yasma'u, the mab sami'a. So the shariba, yashrabu. So if you throw five in your pocket, yashrabu, tashrabu, tashrabu, ashrabu, nashrabu. So we'll do full conjugation now. So yashrabu, ya represents alamat mudariya, and if there is nothing attached, that means it is huwa, huwa yashrabu, he drinks. Shariba is he drank. Yashrabu is he drinks. Yashrabani. So we have ya again alamat mudariya and alif musanna. So when you see ani, the sign of dual, so yashrabani ya and ani represents two of the men. Two of the men. So ya here is for men. Yashrabani. Yashrabuna, again ya and waw represents hum. So yashrabu, yashrabani, yashrabuna, he drinks, they both people drinks, and all of the men drinks. And tashrabu is here. Tashrabani is again ta and alif musanna is two women drank, and we have tash yashrabna, ya and nunu niswa represents hunna, yashrabna. So all the women drink. Then again anta, again same thing, tashrabu, tashrabani. So you drink, you both drink, depending on the sentence, because they both look similar. Tashrabu, tashrabu, depending how it is used in the sentence, so we know whether it is addressing a feminine or it is addressing a male in front of you. Tashrabu, tashrabu. Again, tashrabani is the same thing, depending on the sentence, what is coming before or after, we can know whether it is speaking about two women, third person, or two men in front of you. Tashrabani is you both drank. And tashrabuna, ta and waw, it means that we are talking in front of us, second person. You all drink. Represent to antum, tashrabuna. Anti, tashrabina. So here, anti, the ya represents the file. So tashrabina. So ta and ya, it is anti in front of you, the feminine, singular. Tashrabu is male singular, tashrabina is feminine singular. And tashrabani, the same thing, depending on the sentence, we will know whether it is talking about two feminine third person, or two males in front of you, or two females in front of you. You both drink. And tashrabna, so you will all the women in front of you drink. Ashrabu, I drink. Nashrabu, we drink. So this is mudariya. So we do the word kharaja. Kharaja means he came out. Kharaja, dwell, kharaju, all the men, kharajat, feminine singular, kharajata, feminine dwell, and kharajna is all those women came out. Kharajta, kharajtuma, kharajtum, anta, antuma, antum, male. Kharajti, kharajtuma, kharajtunna, anti, antuma, antunna. I came out, kharajtu, we came out, kharajna. So kharaja is bab nasara, nasara yansuru. So kharaja means he came out in the past tense. So we have yakhruju, he comes out. He's coming out. Yakhruju. Yakhrujani, they both mean they come out. And yakhrujuna is ya and wow represents home. All of those men, so all of the men come out. They will come out. Takhruju, you come out. So kharajat is she came out. Takhruju is she come out. So takhrujani is two feminine. Two females, they come out. And yakhrujna means all the women, they come out. Ya and nunu niswa. So we have again takhruju in front of you, anta. Depending on the sentence, you will know whether it is hiya or anta. And takhrujani, again, in front of you, two women, you're telling you both come out. And takhrujuna means all of the men, they come out or they're coming out. Takhrujina is anti in front of you, feminine, that you come out. You are coming out. And takhrujani, again depending on the sentence, we know these three, whether it is dual, antuma, or it is homa, depending on the sentence. And takhrujina, so you're telling all the women in front of you, females, that you all come out. Akhruju, I come out. And nakhruju, we come out. So, going to certain adjectives which you have learned before, like atashanu, jaw'anu, mal'anu, ghadbanu, and farhanu, we've learned that these all comes as mamnu' min as-sarf, and they are dipped out because they are ending with single dhamma, and they have a pattern which is fa'alanu. See, atashanu, fa'alanu. This pattern is for a masculine, is a masculine pattern for addressing the men. If the man has to say, huwa atshanu. So you have a pattern for a feminine as well. The feminine pattern is fa'ala. So if a woman or feminine has to use an adjective, there's a feminine adjective which is called on the pattern fa'ala. So atshanu will be atsha, jaw'anu will be jaw'a. See, fa'ala, jaw'a, mal'anu, which is been full, will be mal'a. Ghadbanu will be ghadba, farhanu will be farha. So this is a pattern for the adjectives which comes with feelings. All these things related to the feelings, and they're all in the masculine form, they're diptote, and here they end with alif maksura. Okay, that's the sign of muannath. For this is for singular. So if a single person is telling, ana atshanu, and if a feminine is telling, ana atsha. But if it is for plural, so there is a, your singular for fa'alanu and fa'ala, for the plural, for jam'u, for both masculine and feminine, we have only one pattern, which is comes on a pattern fi'alun. Fi'alun, for example, if you say hamidun jaw'anu, hamid is hungry. So if you want to say all the students, the at-tullabu jia'un, so fi'alun, so you say jia'un. Maryam jaw'a, at-talibatu jia'un. So what we need to see is, we see ya here, but we don't see ya in the singular. Because when the kasra comes, then kasra and waw, they are not compatible. So this waw, it turns into ya. That's the reason why we see waw in the singular form and ya in the plural form. Jiyaun. Originally it will be jiwaun, but because it is not compatible for the phonetics reason, so it's turned into ya. So then we have Khalid, Khalidun Atshanu. So what will be the plural? So we, for example, Al Awladu Aitashun. So we say Fi'alun Aitashun. So if you say Aminatu Atsha, it's Fa'ala. And Al Banatu Aitashun. So for both masculine and feminine is the same pattern, Fi'alun. So Ibrahimu Shab'anu. This Shab'anu means full. You say At-Tullabu Shiba'un. All the students are full. Say Fatimatu Shab'a. She is full. Fatima is full. And At-Talibatu Shiba'un. Al-Mudarrisu Ghadbanu. Al-Mudarrisu Ghadbanu. So if you want to say Al-Mudarrisuna, say Ghidabun. The teachers are angry. Al-Mudarrisatu Ghadba. The teacher, the female teacher is angry. And Al-Mudarrisatu Ghidabun. So it's the same pattern. So there is, however, there is some exception. For example, Kaslanu. So you say feminine will be Kasla, but the plural will be Kusala. We just have to remember this. So At-Tullabu Kusala. For example, Khadijatu Kasla. Kasla means lazy. Kaslanu means lazy. And At-Talibatu Kusala. So there's a little bit of irregular adjective. So just going to do certain questions and answers here just to refresh ourselves. For example, we say here to understand the verb and the fa'il. Fa'al and fa'il, how it is addressed. So if it is a male in front of you, you say Azahabta ilal madrasati al-yawma. But if it is a feminine, you say Azahabti. But whenever there is a Zahabta or Zahabti, the answer will be Zahabtu, both. You say Naam Zahabtu, yes, I went. You say Mata Raja'ta, when did you? Raja'a means to return. So when did you return? Raja'ta will be male if it is a masculine male person in front of you, or if it is a female you are asking, you will say Mata Raja'ti, when did you return from Madrasati? Say Raja'tu. So again, if it is a Ta, it becomes Tu. Raja'tu Ba'da Salati Zuhr. So again, with this concept, Ayya Suratin. Ayya is a special mudaf, and it always comes mudaf ilayhi. Here ayya comes meaning as a maf'ulun bihi for this fa'il mutaaddi, which is qara'a. So ayya suratin qara'ta ba'd salat al-fajr. So which surah did you read after salat al-fajr? You can say qara'tu surat al-baqara. Surat al-baqara. So again here ayya suratin. So ayya, because it is a fa'il mutaaddi, hafiza, he memorized. So memorized what? So it needs a maf'ulun bihi. So when there is a verb coming and we have to ask which, then this ayyu will become ayya because it is attached to the fa'il. So ayya suratin hafizta hadha al-usbu'. Hadha is ismu ishara followed by alis badal. So this week, usbu' means week. You can say hafiztu, hafiztu suratan naba'i. So I memorize suratan naba'a. So again here we are just asking question about two things. So whenever there is a two things you are asking about, so we separate them with a and am. So first comes with a and second comes after am. Abil ma'i, is it with cold water? Bil ma'il barid. Barid means cold. Ma'i is water. So it's not man'ud. Is it with cold water? Ghasalta is you washed. Wajhaka is your face. Is it with cold water you washed your face, or with hot water? Bil ma'il har. Har means hot. So this is just to show that A and Am, they have to be separated. If you say Aghasalt al-wajhaka bil ma'il barid am bil ma'il har, that will be wrong. So abil ma'il barid ghasalta wajhaka am bil ma'il har. You can say ghasaltu, I washed, wajhi. See, here we need to understand whenever there is a fa'il, the ta will turn into tu, which means I, and ka, which is damir muttasil, will turn into ya, which means mine. So wajhi, so I washed my face bil ma'il barid, with cold water. So man ghasala, who washed? Khameesuka wa mindiluka, who washed your shirt and your handkerchief. You can say ummi ghasalat. So you can say, either you can make it as a jumlatul ismiya or jumlatul fa'il, both will be correct. Say ghasalat ummi will be jumlatul ismiya fa'il fa'il, and here ummi ghasalat is jumlatul ismiya mubtada mudaf ilayhi, and ghasalat will be khabar. So we just need to understand, inshallah. So this is a very easy exercise from the previous lesson, just to say how to use the fa'il for the feminine, for masculine and feminine. Asharibta shaya ya hamid, and if it is feminine, say asharibti shaya, asharibti shaya ya su'ad. The same thing here, you just have to say akatabta darsa, is me akatabti darsa. Ya aliyun, say ya khadija. Aghasalta wajhaka ya akhi, aghasalti wajhaki, see wajhaka and wajhaki. Ya ukhti, ayya suratin hafista ya buniyya. You can say ayya suratin hafisti ya binti. Afahimta darsa, afahimta darsa al-jadeeda ya Hashim. Did you understand the new lesson ya Hashim? So you say afahimta darsa jadeeda ya Fatima. So you can use any name. So if you are reading without vowel signs, so you have to understand that here there are different fa'ils here. So but in the writing pattern, they all look the same. So depending on the sentence, you should be able to recognize who is the being addressed to. For example, ana, ana means we know zahabtu, zahabtu, ana zahabtu ilal matar. So again, here you see ya yusufa, so means it is for the masculine and it's in front of you. Ya means harfu nida, means the person is in front of you. So it will be zahabta ilal mal'ab. Mal'ab is a playground. So la'iba means he played, mal'ab means the way you play, it's playground. Azhabta ilal mal'ab, ya, did you go to the playground, O Yusuf? See, ukhti, so you're telling about ukhti, so it is here, third person. So this is ukhti zahabat. So here it is, zahabat ilal mustashwa. So we have to understand in the sentence who is being talked about. You say ya Fatimatu, so means it will be adhahabti ilal maktabati ya Fatima, did you go to the library ya Fatima. So we also did lima. So lima is originally limaza, means why. So maza on its own is what. So if you have harf shar li, then it be limaza, means why. So the short form is lima. So lima is written, if it is a question, something comes after lima, then you have written in this fashion. Lima kharajta min al fasli, why did you come out of the class? So when there is a question, like for example, akharajta min al fasli, if you say naam, then if you want to say why, and you're not asking anything more, then you have to add this ha, ha usakti, a silent ha, just to add emphasis. So lima, for example, lima darabta hadha alwaladu, why did you hit this? So there is a change in the tone when you add the house sakti. So if you say adarabta hadha alwaladu, did you hit this boy? If you say naam, you say lima, why? So just by understanding the patterns, you know that it gives a picture's meaning, how it is being addressed. So we'll finish our class here today, inshallah. So what we'll do is we'll start a new lesson in our next class. Till then, try and write and practice, and inshallah we'll see you again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.